see the way those guys looked at us?
Who wants to go skinny dipping?
No!
We got your friend!
They captured Allison!
Tucker and Dale vs. Evil play on just about every horror movie stereotype there can be. The backwoods hillbillies who kidnap and kill the prom queen, the spooky backwoods evil dead-like house where a brutal murder happened, and an unexpected group of teens stranded in the woods as they're slowly picked off, killed in gruesome, vicious, and gory ways. Tucker and Dale heighten it all, but deliver it in a very charming and innocent way. We know backwoods hillbillies from movies such as Deliverance and Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but Tucker and Dale are completely different. The pair are just two blue-collar best friends with simple needs on a much-needed vacation to a fixer-upper vacation home in the woods. But if Hollywood has taught us anything, this simply can't be true, can it? Backwoods hillbillies are inbred, dirty, nasty, evil things, right? In come our college spring breakers, led by the vengeful, hillbilly-hating Chad, the unlikely antagonist. What ensues afterward is utter chaos. Think of every horror movie you've ever seen, or even heard of, and imagine that. Blood and guts, gore, spilling everywhere, drowning in it, drenched in it. Okay, good. Now, try laughing about it. It's an odd request, but that's the exact reaction you'll get from watching this movie. Nobody really kills anyone. It's all odd, gory, completely unpredictable happenstance, and although you might question yourself about laughing at it, you just can't help but let go and enjoy it. Seeing this movie in the theaters was a joy. I've seen plenty of comedies where I've giggled or said I've liked it, but I've never really been affected by it while in the process of watching it. I was rolling, the critics were rolling, and the audience was rolling. Is this movie worth the price of admission? Yeah. Even if you are a little squeamish, buck up, baby, because this movie is a laugh riot.
Well, I have to agree with you. I really did enjoy that for both Tucker and Dale. Like, they both, it surprised me, because at first from the trailers, I didn't know if it was going to be that, like, really funny. I thought it was just going to be, like, one of those scary movie type parodies.
A horror movie spoof. At first, I thought it was going to be, like, a scary movie type movie.
Yeah.
But it really surprised me. Tudyk. Yes.
Firefly.
Yes. Oh, I know him. Yes. Both the actors were great. They were great character actors, which I didn't expect from them. And it was just so goofy and gory, like really gory. But yeah. They played it off so well. Mm-hmm.
Katrina Bowden was.
She's
used to just playing just like the static character in 30 Rock.
Exactly.
So I didn't expect that much from her.
But it kind of worked. I mean, she's just your typical teenager caught in this random predicament, and it worked for her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it was kind of reminded me of like a funnier version of like Final Destination, because you knew going into the movie that each of the teenagers were going to get killed in some way, but it was just basically like, how are they going to get killed?
Exactly.
And one person goes through a wood chipper. Ooh.
Yeah, yeah. And watching this movie, you can kind of see the deaths coming because, like a lot of horror movies, they mimic the deaths, but they come in such odd and bizarre ways. And it's kind of like, why am I laughing at this, like I said? But it's beautiful.
I agree. I think it was worth the price of
admission. Yes, Tucker and Dale is definitely worth the price of admission, and it's out now, so go see it.